I used Gmail for a long time, both the free account and then I paid for Google Workspace, but it felt like prices kept increasing, features were decreasing, and I kept hearing about privacy and security issues and even hacks when it came to Gmail. And so 8 years ago, I finally switched from Gmail to Fastmail. Fastmail is an incredible email provider that's private and secure, has great apps on mobile, one of the best web interfaces you'll see from an email provider, and it includes calendars, contact syncing, notes, even cloud storage for your files. You can use tons of your custom domains, which I have a bunch. And Fastmail does it all cheaper than Google Workspace. Even at its cheapest plan, Google Workspace is $8.40 a month per user with 30 gigs of storage, or $7 a month if you pay for a year, where Fastmail is just $6 per month, or $5 if you pay for the full year. It comes with double the storage, 60 gigabytes versus 30, and you can always add more later. Plus, it comes with a ton of other features with more privacy and security in mind. Now, my thanks to Fastmail for sponsoring this video, but I have been personally paying for Fastmail for 8+ years, and I have the literal receipts to prove it. It is that good, and I love the service that much. So I'm going to share the key features that brought me to Fastmail, how easy it was moving from Gmail, the powerful features it offers for things like custom domains and even multiple users, and why I'm never going back. So when I was looking for alternatives to Gmail, I needed the migration process to be super easy. I wanted custom domains and, of course, privacy and security. Well, I found Fastmail had all of that for a cheaper price. We'll talk more about security and privacy in a minute, but Fastmail allowed me to bring over my tons of custom domain names. It even has features like masked email, which is like the hide my email feature directly from Apple, but Fastmail does it too. And you can even generate them on demand in the Fastmail app, which is wild. Plus, you can snooze messages, mute replies in conversation threads, pin messages, and more. So step one was migration. Keeping all your old emails and history is important, and Fastmail can migrate directly from all of these services, including Gmail or Google Workspace, Office 365, your iCloud email, and more. You can also upload your contacts and calendars if you want to move that to Fastmail as well. The migration was super fast, taking I think under an hour, and all my Google Workspace emails were now in Fastmail, searchable, indexed, and ready to go. It even brought over all the folders that I had in my Google Workspace account, and it will even move the rules and filters you had in Gmail to your Fastmail account. And let's talk about rules for 1 second, because that's one reason why I didn't use iCloud email as my default. Here in iCloud Mail, you actually can use custom domains, but only up to 5, and I have way more than that. But if you wanted to create a filter or rule in iCloud Mail, you are very limited. You can only choose who the message is from, address to, and if the subject contains keywords. That's not enough for me. I want to be able to filter emails based on the content or the body text of the message. Well, Fastmail allows me to do exactly that. Here in Fastmail settings, under filters and rules, one, this is where you can import those Gmail filters you might have. But when you create a new rule, you get a ton of options. Not only if a message is from or to a certain address, but Fastmail has a built-in VIP feature to designate certain senders, whether or not messages have an attachment, and you can also filter by text found in the body of a message. My email pro tip, which I share regularly, I always create a filter where if the word unsubscribe or manage my email preferences are in an email body, that goes directly to my newsletter folder and skips my inbox. Cuts down on spam a ton. Once I knew I could set up my filters and rules just how I wanted, then came adding my custom domains. And yes, I had a bunch of them. I was able to add all of them here in Fastmail. I adjusted the MX records in my domain registrar, and now I can have as many aliases for as many domains as I want. You can also create aliases up here and have multiple users with a bunch of team settings where they can access their own inbox, have generic contact emails for your business, and more. And another great feature in Fastmail is masked email. Maybe you're wanting to create an account, but you don't want them to have your personal email address. This is a masked address like Apple's Hide My Email feature. You can create more if you would like. Use these when you're creating an account or maybe buying something on a website that you don't want to have your actual email address. And then if you ever find that you're getting a lot of spam from that email address, you can delete it and it will stop immediately. And I love that so many of these features are also available on the Fastmail mobile app. If you go to Fastmail, I can tap the 3 dots up here and you'll see I can create a new masked email address right from my phone. So if I'm on the go needing to create a quick account, I can create that masked email right here. Fastmail search is also great. It actually helped me find those old renewal emails from my Fastmail account from 8 years ago in seconds. Also, if you just want to use the Fastmail app on your iPhone, you can have swipe actions like move and delete. You have access to your calendars, contacts, your folders, and notes all right here. Now, personally, I like using the stock mail app on iPhone, Mac, and iPad, and you can set up the Fastmail account just as easily there. Here in your Fastmail settings, you can go to Privacy and Security, Manage App Passwords and Access. Then you would create a new app password. You can sign in both with two-factor authentication, and Fastmail already supports passkeys. Then you can choose whether you want to sync mail contacts and calendars, if you just wanted to do mail, and it'll generate that password. You can scan this QR code and Fastmail will be added to your mobile device. Now, just like in Gmail and other email providers, you can snooze emails. You can choose later today, this evening, tomorrow, or a specific date and time. And you can also pin messages to the top of your inbox. This way, if it's an important email you know you need to respond to, it'll live at the top of your inbox. Or if it's a long conversation and there's lots of replies and you'd like to mute those replies, you can choose this. You can mute the replies for that email conversation. When you're composing an email, you can choose from all the addresses you have set up in your Fastmail account. And of course, it has schedule send if you want this email to be delivered at a later date. There's also lots of visual customizations, both for viewing your email and color themes. If you want to match your brand, maybe you're using this with your team, you can do all of that here in the Fastmail settings. And like I mentioned before, Fastmail also supports calendars, contacts, notes, and files. So here you can set up the calendar and use CalDAV to add it to the stock calendar app on your Apple devices. You can even sync your notes and cloud files. So if you do have the instance where you want to share a file, maybe temporarily, and you don't want to pay for another cloud service, you can use Fastmail for that too. So here I have an image saved. That's my tech podcast, by the way, Primary Technology. You should check it out. But I can get a share link for this file and someone else can download it. And I've done it all in Fastmail. Plus that Fastmail app on your iPhone or iPad also has the files right here. You can upload, share, and more. When you're in the Google Suite, it feels like there's an app for every different feature. You would have to go to Google Drive to manage files, Gmail for that, Google Calendar for events, where Fastmail has it all in one place and easy to access. Fastmail also has offline support, so you can read, write draft messages, and manage your events, and then it will sync once you connect back to the internet. And Fastmail is so confident, there's no lock-in. So if you ever want to migrate to another email service provider, which I know you won't, I haven't, there's no lock-in, and you can move wherever you would like later. And a side note, if you're looking for even more control over your spam and filtering, you can connect SaneBox with Fastmail seamlessly. That's actually what I've done with my email. You literally just log into your Fastmail account through SaneBox. That creates folders here in your list. And then you get features like Sane Black Hole, where I can drag an email to Sane Black Hole, and that sender is gone forever. I will never see an email from that address again. I can snooze using folders here. And that's really useful when you're using the stock mail app on iPhone or Mac, because I can choose to just move a message to one of my SaneBox folders, like Sane Tomorrow, and that email will leave my inbox, but return tomorrow morning. Apple stock mail apps don't have a legitimate snooze feature, but now I can do it with SaneBox and Fastmail. SaneBox also filters emails that are not important or low priority into a Sane Later folder. I usually check that once a day, and that all helps me focus on the emails that matter. And finally, you can trust Fastmail to be both private and secure with your email. All your data is stored on encrypted disks. All communication between their data center servers and your device is encrypted. Like I mentioned before, they support two-factor authentication and passkeys. And the Fastmail Bug Bounty Program encourages third-party review of their security practices. So listen, I'm gonna be real for a second. I was so excited when Fastmail wanted to sponsor this video because this is one of the easiest ones I've ever done. I pay for Fastmail and have done it for 8+ years. I love it, using it for my personal email, which is also my work email for YouTube and creator stuff. And so if you want to use custom domains, have powerful filtering, and all the great features that you might be looking at Google Workspace for, Fastmail is just a better option. I heard about it from podcasters and creators I love for years, and now that I've been using it for almost a decade, I can say you will love Fastmail and you'll never look back. There's going to be a special affiliate link down in the video description if you want to sign up today. Set it up on your Apple devices. It works great on your iPhone, iPad, and your Mac. Either if you want to use the stock mail app, which is how I do it, or use their Fastmail app, which is great also. Plus you get the calendars, contacts, files, masked email, all those features, plus it's private and secure. So try Fastmail today. The link is in my description. And if you want to see how Fastmail works seamlessly with SaneBox, I did a whole video on that. Both services I pay for personally, but both have been kind enough to sponsor this channel. So you can check out my latest video on that up here. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that like button. If you have questions about Fastmail, SaneBox, or anything, leave comments below this video. And I'll leave another video right here that YouTube thinks you'll really love. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.